Yeah, welcome. Yeah, this record sound also. So here you can see if you want to create any menu, create role menu, you can do that. Okay, as of now, let us leave that now. Then, okay, let us leave this first part alone. So we come to the icons. This green color icon, top tick icon, this is equivalent to your enter, pressing the enter in your keyboard. Okay. So either you can press enter in keyboard or you can click this icon. And this is called as text area. Here you normally enter the transaction code. Transaction code is the shortcut to carry out certain transactions. For example, if I want to create a sales order, I must go through this menu. I will click the logistics, sales and distribution, sales, order, create. Either I can go through this menu part, else I can click the corresponding transaction code directly. For example, the transaction code for create is VA01. So in the text area, I can click the VA01, and it will take me to the corresponding screen directly. So this text area is the place where you can enter the transaction codes and execute your transaction. Okay. So next one is grayed out, which is the It's not necessary only to, depends on the transaction code. Sometimes like you can have transaction codes with, say even if you see in the same screen, see the third line from here, /DEV1/TSMA, that is a transaction code. Okay, so basically if you just think of this way, transaction code is the easy way to get into the transaction directly without going through this menu part. Okay. So in the text area you enter the transaction code. So next one is save grayed out, which means like if you are inside any sales order or delivery, there you have to save the transaction, then it will be enabled. Then next to three icons is like your web browser's back and forward button. Okay, this first one is grayed out. This is third one, I will go here itself. Okay. Now you can see all these things are active now because I can save this sales order. If I don't want, I can go back by pressing this button. Okay. And next one is the exit button. If I press this, it will take me to previous screen. Okay. But if I press this exit, it will take me to the easy access screen directly. Okay. And next one is the cancel button. For example, if you are inside of any transaction and it is not allowing you to save or it is not allowing you to exit also, and in that cases you can use this cancel button. If you cancel it, it will just cancel the transaction, that's it. Okay. Then you have the print icon, which means if that's a sales order, if you want to print that, you can do that. Okay. Then the next two icons are your find icons. That is why they are given in the binocular format. Okay. Then is your first page and page navigation. Here you cannot see. I mean, this will be useful in case of reports. When you are typing a report, it will be going into more than one page. So in that case, there is no scroll bar like like MS Word. So in those scenarios, you have to use these buttons. Okay. First one will take you to the first page, and this one take you to the last page, the remaining items will take you to the previous and next page. Okay. So what you are seeing now is called as a transaction. It is a transaction window. Okay. In SAP, you are allowed to have 6 parallel transaction windows, which is each one is called as a session. For example, right now I am creating a sales order. So let me say sales order. So suddenly I remember I want to enter a particular article, whether that article is available in stock or not. Okay. So if I want to check that, I don't need to go out of the system, I mean go out of my current screen. Instead I can always create a new session. In the new session, it will give you a new window like that. Okay, in this new session I can execute my transaction. So let me say I just want to see the stock of a particular article. So T-A-210. So I didn't leave the sales order. Instead, when the sales order was very much on, I went into this screen, into the another screen and saw my functionality. So this is the use of having more than one session. But in SAP, at the maximum you can have 6 sessions only. So let me click, right now there are 3, 4, 5, 6. If I click the next one, it will say maximum number of sessions reached. So in that case, you have to close any one of the session and then proceed. Alt tab only. That is the only functionality here. There is no option like window in our MS Word. So that is not here, but only thing is like you have to use the Alt tab. Then you have the help icon. Help icon will take you to the, it will give you all kind of help. For example, if you are stuck up with, let me say, in the sales order, I am not sure of what this particular field is, which one I have selected right now. So I don't know what it is. So if I keep the my cursor on the particular screen and press the help, then the system will display a help window. You can call this directly by pressing F1 also. For example, now my icon is in the sales order. Can you see that? I don't know what this field is about. So instead of selecting this and going to the help, I can directly press F1. F1 is the help functionality for your, all your Windows, MS Windows. And you notice that if you press F1 accidentally in your keyboard, it will pop up the help window. The same here. So you can, the help functionality in SAP is very extensive, which means using this help functionality, you can get the details of anything in SAP. So if you want to learn more, use this functionality of F1 more. Okay. Then if you are customizing local layout, which means here you can change your color and other things. For example, if you want to, if you have more than one access to SAP, then else if you want to change the color or the feel of the SAP, then you can go and change your color options here, set color to the system. Okay, so only one is set here, so that is not important for us, but one functionality is important in this particular customized local layout button, that is the quick cut and paste. Which means if you want to copy any text in window application, what you will do, you will select the text, you right click and then you choose copy, first you select the text, press Ctrl C, it will be copied and then you will be pressing Ctrl V. But if you choose this quick cut and paste, I can just select it, that's it. But I can paste it anywhere. So this is the easy functionality of quick cut and paste. I just selected the text, that's it. So this is a very useful function. Yeah. Control C and other things. Create new session. Okay. One second. For example, if you know the transaction code, right now I am in one screen. Okay. I want to enter the transaction code. I mean, I know the transaction code which I want to see, but I want to do it in next screen. What happens is, if I enter the create new session, and then it will, I have to go there and execute it. Okay. Else, I can use the functionality of creating a shortcut. Okay, for example, VA01 and I mean this shortcut will be sent to your desktop. Okay, so let me cancel this. Okay. And then that is not important functionality, you can leave it. Okay. So then you have this menu, you have this favorite. The favorite is very much like to our favorites in Internet Explorer. If you are using any transaction regularly, then you can add it in your favorite. For example, I am adding one transaction. My transaction code is VA01 because I am going to create sales orders more often. So I need not go into the long menu path and execute it every time. And I don't want to key in my transaction code also. So what I can do is I can enter the transaction code and add it in the favorites. And if I could see another transaction, SPRO, that is the customizing. So instead of entering the transaction code in there, I can just double click this and I can go into the transaction. So this is the favorites functionality. No, I don't recommend the going reading the list of transactions. So as long as you are learning, I suggest you to go through this menu path, because once you use this menu path, you can understand why certain things are grouped on certain. I mean, on what basis they are grouped together. Okay, so initially, till then, I will give you the list of transaction codes, but not now. Towards the end of the class, I will give. Because I want you to know, the problem of using transaction code is, people just remember the transaction code. They don't know where it is available in the system. If it is available in the system, why it is placed there? So that logic cannot be, you cannot understand that. So you cannot understand the grouping. So that is why I don't recommend you to read any kind of transaction code or by heart any transaction code, at least for a while. Okay, so this is our menu, okay, what you see. And other than that, it's okay. So for example, our most of the activities will be revolving the logic only. Okay. So just now, I clicked this and I went to sales and distribution, sales, order. Okay, here I can see the transaction code. Okay. So this is not by default. If you go through this menu path in your system, you won't be finding this transaction code. So to enable that, go to extra settings and enable this display technical name. If you enable this only, you will get that technical name. So right now, I am disabling it. So if I go to logistics, sales and distribution, sales, order, I can see only the create change and display. I don't see the transaction code. So see there, go to extra, settings, display technical name. Okay. This is one customizing. And another customizing is, so we all are aware, like we use the dot or full stop for our decimal points. Whereas in Europe, SAP is a German product. I think you are aware of that. Okay. In Europe, they use comma for decimals and full stop for three digit that thousands. Okay. So this is, for example, if I want to create a, I mean, enter a value of 125,000.75. In SAP, I have to enter the 125.000.75. So this will lead to a confusion to the most of the users. So to change to your numerical format, go to user profile, own data, go to parameters, sorry, default. Here you can choose the appropriate decimal notation. By default, SAP comes with this one, which means comma for decimals and dot for thousands. Okay. So you can change it to your comfortable format. Own data. Yeah, German do that. So you can do that in system, user profile, own data, and you can set your parameters. Okay, so this is what navigation is about. Okay, and I have your email ID, please. Can you type it in the IM window? No, it can be forced to by the user. Yeah. For mass changing, you can do it via basis. That your basis consultant will be able to help that. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. It's merchant_abit2000@yahoo.com. Yeah. And create yours. Type and enter. No, it's just you didn't enter. Send message. Click send message. Okay, I will type it. SJR@yahoo.com. SJR or SKR? JSN. Yeah, okay, fine. Okay, fine. Well, you store this mail ID. Yeah, this is better, yeah. Okay, so this is the navigation of SAP. So do one thing, so go through the system, I mean like, how many sessions you can create by maximum? Six sessions, okay, correct. Okay. So what are the two type of minutes we normally find in SAP? Easy access menu, and another one is customizing. Another one is customizing. SCRO. Yeah. The transaction code to, I mean, if you are in the SCRO right now, so let me say, if you want to go to the easy access menu, you can either use this exit button or you can use the transaction code S000/N. Okay, I wanted to tell this /N and /O. For example, right now I am in the mid of this screen. Okay, in the mid of checking the stock. Now I have to create a sales order. I have two options. One, I can go to easy access screen and then create a sales order. Else, I know what my transaction code is. So I can prefix with /N. /N stands for new session in the same window. So I can use slash n and enter the transaction code VA01. It will automatically take me to the screen instead of going to the Yeah, it's not a new session. It is the same session but new transaction. So if you are inside any transaction, if you want to come to EC menu, you can just press slash n. Okay. Else this menu can be accessed using the transaction code S000. S000. Okay. So let me go into some other transaction. Okay, right now I am in SPRO screen. I want to get into EC access. I can either enter only slash n and press enter, else I can enter slash n yes 000. Okay. So these are the two options. Okay. It takes me to the previous menu. Okay, then now easy access menu. Yeah. Okay. So this is the SAP navigation. I'll do one thing, I will send you an assignment regarding the navigation. You just make yourself familiar and comfortable with this. Then we will catch up. Recording, do anybody of you have FTP access? No, in my previous sessions, the students used to have the FTP. Give me the FTP. Let me try, because it's not, I tried that also, but it's not uploading properly. No, any web-based this thing, it's not getting uploaded. That is the problem. That's what I said. Any web-based upload is having problem. Anyway, let me try any of this. But if any FTP is available, if any FTP account is available, then it will be very much easy. Okay, so I will look into this. I will ask somebody of my friends. Okay. Yeah, it used to be useful for my previous students. I'll do that. Let me check at least with their FTPs. Okay. And one thing is tomorrow I won't be available this time. So we'll meet on Friday. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, same time, yeah. Okay, I'll send you this thing now, assignment now. Do that. Yeah, I'll send you now. Okay, we'll catch up. See you. Bye.